moving.
Oh, you're going to see Eazy-E come out. Dookie Dog's coming out today. What's up, guys? My name is Josh Sutledge. I am the BJJ Strength Coach. We have another training vlog coming at you. In this training vlog, you guys are going to learn how to Zercher squat the correct way, why the Zercher box squat is one of my favorite exercises to build strength, specifically for wrestling and jiu-jitsu athletes, and what you should be thinking about as you're kind of formatting a strength session and you're going to be using Zercher box squats as a main movement, and how you can use those things so you can improve your overall physicality on the mat to win more matches and get injured less. We have a pretty live crew this morning, so it should be a good training session.
Ain't this what they've been waiting for?
Yep.
Ready?
Yep.
Woo. Damn.
Yeah. Make it right. Make it right. Set up. Yeah. Yes, sir. Woo. Good job. How was that? Yeah. Hell yeah, bro.
Come on, Zach.
There you go. Yes, sir. Yep. Nice. Come on now.
Don't let up. Don't let up. Come on, keep going. Don't let up.
That's it. That's it.
Keep that pace. Come on.
Yes, yep. Sir.
Don't let up, come on.
Yeah.
Don't stop. Don't stop, Zach, let's go. Don't rest, come on. Yep, keep going.
That's it, come on, let's go.
Atta kid,
let's
keep
go.
It going.
Let's go.
Don't let up, let's go. Don't let up.
Yes, sir, come on.
Come on.
Come on.
Let's go. You got more, you got more. Let's go. You got more. You got more, Z.
Come on.
You got more, let's get it. Pull, let's go. Pull, yeah, pull, pull.
Let's go. Yeah, come on. Let's go, that's it.
Get it. Woo. Damn it.
Damn it.
Let's go, Jay.
Yeah, come on, Jay.
Yep. There you go. Five. Ten. Come on, Jay. Yeah, come on now.
Yeah.
There you go. Don't let up, Jay. Don't let up. Don't stop, Jay. Yep. Don't let up. Come on.
Come on now.
Yep. Let's go. Get another. Come on. Yep, another. Let's go. One at a time, Jay. One at a time. One at a time. Let's go. Yep. Another one. Let's go. Yep, another. Let's go. There you go.
Come on.
Don't let up. Let's go, Z. Don't let up. Come on. Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. Let's go. Yes, sir.
There you go. Yep.
Come on, Z. Don't let up.
Yes, sir.
Don't let up. Where you at, Z?
Come on. Come on.
Where you at? go.
Yeah. Yeah. Nice. Take 35.
Yes, sir. Let's go.
Yes, sir.
Woo. 28. Oh. Nice job, man.
Come on, set.
Oh, this is a good song. This is a good song. It's for my dog, Sully. Yeah.
Yep, come on. Yep. Let's get it. Let's go. Ascend. Come on, Jay. Yep. That's 15. 16. Yep.
Let's go.
That's 20. Yep. Yep. Woo. Let's get it. Come on. Let's go. One more. 25. Woo.
That was rough. Oh man, 25, I got some work to do. I think my best ever was, it was on rings. It was over 30, but just under 40, I can't remember. So, got a lot of work to do. We have a max power output test. I heard the man behind the camera talking tons of trash. He has one leg, I got two legs and two arms. I'm older, I'm not as heavy, I'm not as great of a wrestler. But I have two legs. I got that going for me. For an upper body only test, I got two legs. So we'll see how it goes. Go! 6'2", 6", just like my dog Stitch.
217, 311. 408, 457, 488, 505.
529.
Oh!
581! 581
though! Let's go! Yep! Yep,
let's go!
Yep!
Yep!
Oh! Oh! Oh!
What the hell?
664!
So we just finished up a killer training session with the AM crew. What we did today was we worked up to a 1-3 rep max on Zercher box squats. And Zercher box squats are an incredible exercise for both wrestling and jiu-jitsu because it's a great way for you to be able to increase your overall strength on the mat. And it's very specific to the physiological demands of wrestling and jiu-jitsu. When you're wrestling or doing jiu-jitsu, you have to have a strong upper back position. If you have a weak upper back, your posture is gonna get broken down. And one of the best ways to be able to apply your techniques in jiu-jitsu and in wrestling is to first break down the posture of your opponent. If you're in a strong wrestling stance and you wanna shoot in for a takedown, as long as your opponent is in their wrestling stance, you're not gonna have a whole lot of success. You need to find a way to get them out of their stance. So that oftentimes means breaking down their posture. Now, if you know on the receiving end of that, if you have a strong upper back because you've been doing tons of Zercher box squats, you're going to be less likely to get your posture broken down. And that's a big reason. That's a big reason why we do Zercher box squats and why we go heavy on Zercher box squats, is to help strengthen our upper back. The other thing that's great about Zercher box squats is that you do get the bar in a double underhook position, which is very common in wrestling and jiu-jitsu. And the other thing is that when we squat to a box, it's a static overcome by dynamic movement. Now, static overcome by dynamic, there's a lot of fancy words, but basically that means you have to be strong and powerful and explosive from a dead stop position. You think about when most people squat, you know, ass to grass, they kind of bounce off their calves or bounce out of the hole, which there's a lot of value and validity to doing that. But oftentimes in wrestling and jiu-jitsu, we don't always have the luxury of being able to bounce off of our calves or, you know, bounce out of the hole when we're doing a certain technique. We sometimes have to hold a static position, and when the opportunity strikes, we have to be ready to explode. And so when we sit on the box, it helps mimic that a little bit. You're able to sit back on the box from a dead stop position, and then from here, you have to explode and be powerful as you stand up. So those are a few reasons why I'm a huge fan of the Zurcher box squat. What really makes the Zurcher box squat special is that it's scalable for everybody. Not everyone has the mobility to get their hands behind them on a straight bar. Not everyone has access to a fancy SSB bar or maybe a cambered bar of some kind. You can just use a straight bar. We like to use an axial bar just because it's a little bit fatter, feels a little bit more comfortable in the elbows, but it's very versatile for a lot of different athletes in different areas of the country, different areas on what kind of gym equipment you have access to. And then lastly, it's also just super fun to gangster out on Zurcher box squats and get a little boost of confidence. Sometimes when you're doing these other movements, as you're learning them and as you're getting more familiar with them, you may not be able to go heavy on them because there's a technical issue that you're trying to work out, or maybe because you're not super familiar with it. The Zurcher box squat is something that a lot of grapplers are kind of familiar with to start because we get in that double underhook position all the time. We all kind of understand the importance of having a tight upper back, having a strong chest position with our chest up tall, making sure that we're not getting collapsed and getting broken down. So it's a great exercise I like to use with all my wrestling and jiu-jitsu athletes. We gangstered out on it today, working up to 1 to 3 rep max with the AM crew. Followed that up with some conditioning tests and some other rep tests on pull-ups and dips to kind of start the year strong with a good starting point so we can build on that in future training phases and in future workouts. And that being said, that's what we got for today. That was a training session. The Strength Matrix drops on January 1st. Be sure to check that out. If you want a free 4-week strength program that's pulled from the Strength Matrix, all you gotta do is just click the link below, drop your email in there, the program will get emailed to you. I wanna be able to share that with you guys and give you guys an inside look on a passion project of mine, which is the Strength Matrix. My goal for this year is to help 1,000 grapplers win more matches and get injured less. I'd love to have you be part of that journey with me, and I'd love to send you a free 4-week strength program. Just click the link below to get your hands on that. You guys can follow my Instagram, @JoshuaSellers, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace.